Rockstar skipped the update this week for Red Dead Online, and does that mean all hope is lost? Not necessarily. Hang in there, folks. This video was gonna be up way sooner, but while I waited all morning for perhaps some late event week changes to Red Dead Online, turns out that was not necessarily worth the time, and rather than leaving you all in the dark this week with what changed, I have this video here for you today, and since there are no huge discounts or spectacular new bonuses or really anything new this week, we do have a few housekeeping items to go over, and so we'll jump into that first. This may be slightly different than a typical Tuesday update where this is a bunch of different things to discuss, but if you enjoy this video at any point or if you just find it helpful, let me know by dropping a like on it, and if you want to stay up to date with everything Red Dead Redemption 2, Red Dead Online, and even Rockstar Games, consider hitting that subscribe button. So getting right in, anything that dropped in the event week last week for Red Dead Online is still active this week, and so with no refresh that may come as a disappointment to some, especially if there were any of you today who may have been expecting some sort of announcement to follow this silence, considering almost 8 months of no new DLC updates for the game, and then Rockstar doesn't update the game this week at all, surely an announcement was to come, right? Wrong. This game is where the hopeful cowboys and outlaws come to die, and the already hopeless just watch on. Still possible we could get some news this week, but obviously don't lose sleep on it, and don't expect it. But this isn't necessarily an awful event week update to get stuck on. For one, the 50% bonus money and roll XP for legendary bounty hunts is still active, and I was dealing with internet problems pretty much all last week, so I apologize for the shortage of videos recently. Safe to say, I wasn't able to play or stream much either, and so this is a great week for me to actually take advantage of this good money opportunity because I wasn't really able to take advantage of it last week. And of course, 50% could be way better. I mean, just compared to Grand Theft Auto Online, those players get double and triple money bonuses, but the 50% is on the higher end for this game anyway. Sometimes it's even 30%, so 50% is higher than that, I'll take it. We also have a new weekly collection for Madame Nazar's shopping list this week as well. The weekly collection for July 21st to July 27th is the Warrior's Tokens. Check out the Gene Rocky collector map for all locations of each collectible updated in real time every single day, or check out our Discord where my wonderful mod Clouds has all the Madame Nazar collections and daily challenge tips and guides updated for your guys' convenience as well. The link is down in the description of my Discord server. And the Warrior's Tokens weekly collection consists of the Knight of Swords Tarot card, Quartz Arrowhead, and the Harlan Coral Ring. Now, speaking of collections as well, the Legendary Bounty 50% cash bonus is a good time to drag out the payout timer for a half hour so you can cap your pay for that mission. You'll receive the full 100% possible earnings for that Legendary Bounty, and during that time, you can go across the map with the bounty and collect a set of tarot cards and then complete the mission. All in all, doing the actual Legendary Bounty hunt and going after that one collection should take you less than an hour start to finish, and while you collect a set of tarot cards or really anything that you don't need a shovel or a metal detector for because you can't use those during legendary bounties, you can earn up to almost 340 extra dollars on the legendary bounty while you're out collecting that set. And it's a nice and interesting grind this week and probably will change up your playstyle. So at least give it a try once and let me know what you think. Now, besides that, the newcomers who get their bounty hunter license to become a bounty hunter between now and July 27th will receive an additional 200 Red Dead Online dollar reward. And all bounty hunters who rank up once between now and July 27th will also get an extra $100 reward. And of course, if you still haven't received your rewards, but you have maxed out the Bounty Hunter role, you should receive a free treasure map and 10 sticks of volatile dynamite for your determination and continued efforts on the frontier. So definitely go check out either the post office or the camp lockbox for that. Those are the changes Rockstar did make this week to Red Dead Online. Big shout out to everyone who participated in all the numerous types of clown events across PS4, Xbox One, and PC yesterday. I'm sure there will be some awesome compilation videos this week from creators, and definitely keep speaking up if there's something you don't like about this game. Don't let people tell you that anything but praise for this game or Rockstar makes you a hater. Those folks don't play this game anymore, and quite honestly, they couldn't care less about what happens to us active players. Those people who unnecessarily praise this online and say that Rockstar has done a perfect job with it, and we should all be thankful for those weekly collections and, you know, bogus like that. Just judging by the track record so far for this game, and its major problems, those people are either being historically ignorant or just deliberately dishonest to you. And it's up to us to recognize that those are very unserious people with not very serious ideas and should be treated as such. But if you missed the update last week, or you're just wondering everything that is currently active for this week, like all of the bonuses, discounts, and other game changes, stay tuned because we will go over that all in depth right now. First up, headhunters and hired guns can get 50% cash boost and roll XP for successfully completing any legendary bounty mission. Like I said, this will result in a 50% boost to your Red Dead Online money payout and also your roll XP payout for the bounty hunter roll. Funny enough, as I was just about to start recording this commentary, I didn't see this bonus, but it's live in-game now, so that makes this week slightly more tolerable than I thought. But that's the strongest point and the strongest piece of this week's update, though. Moving on, we have a 40% discount on select bandoliers. In the gunsmith, head on over or turn the page in your catalog to take advantage of the Merino bandolier for 40% off, the Coburn bandolier, Higgins bandolier, Espinal double bandolier, and finally the Salizo double bandolier. Those last few I mentioned are actually quite pricey as well, so for those wondering what my outfits and what my clothing items consist of, a big part of it and one of the most notable pieces are the bandoliers, and this is a good week to purchase them if you have not already. Next up though, take 40% off certain coats like the Taranka coat, Dunaway jacket, Finley jacket, Durham coat, Riggs fringe coat, leather duster, sheep's wool jacket, and the bison duster, and also the Hagen coat. Not all of these are featured prominently at the beginning of the coat section in the catalog, so you'll need to do some page flipping to find them all. Just keep that in mind. Female characters can also snag 40% off select skirts as well, like the Creswell skirt, Hadley skirt, Westcott skirt, Kamasa skirt, Prairie skirt, Wash skirt, Guildtown skirt, and also the Constance skirt. Both males and females can also grab 40% off select chaps as well in the catalog. If you check out all the different deals on chaps, like the Cockerel half chaps, Gordillo half chaps, Batwing half chaps, Becker half chaps, and the Alvarado chaps, which are also the ones I have on a few of my outfits, like my DeLobo outfit and also my Longhorn outfit. But you can also check out the Heartland chaps, the Weathered half chaps, the Tan half chaps, Multitone half chaps, and lastly, the Military half chaps for a steal this week. That's it in terms of clothing, but back at the gunsmith as well, check out 50% off the Springfield rifle and the Carcano rifle. The Carcano rifle is used a lot in PvP, whether it's in free roam or in showdowns, and this is also a fun and deadly tool to use in your own PvE grind, so definitely check it out. I still have some more fun shooting with the rolling block rifle, but something about having 6 bullets in the Carcano before I need to reload makes this gun incredibly enjoyable to shoot with, and also one that has a high utility, as you can clear out those moonshine operations or revenue agent roadblocks with ease that you may come across on the frontier. And it's also the perfect weapon to use during the boat moonshine story mission. I know a lot of players like that mission, and there's really no better weapon to use than a Carcano rifle there, especially if you are playing on ruthless difficulty because of the extreme ranges you'll be trying to take enemies out at, and they also have buffed health and do extra damage. Now, the Carcano rifle also will help you this week for the legendary bounties as well, so keep that in mind. But this week at Madame Nazar, take 50% off the Aguila machete, and honestly, this is something that isn't worth your gold at all. You can get the normal machete as well without spending all of that gold, and of course, what else are you gonna do with that money anyway? But if you just want the melee weapon for cheap, you could still definitely get it, because this 50% deal applies to the Aguila machete as well as the normal machete at the fence. You just won't be able to get the roll specific machete, and you'll have to settle for the normal one, but it's okay because I find that one nicer looking anyway, and there's nothing more entertaining than running around like Jason in Friday the 13th and slashing enemies in a mission with a machete. The weekly collection and a Madame Nazar shopping list this week is the whiskey collection. You'll need to collect the Tennessee whiskey, Irish whiskey, and lastly the Scotch whiskey to complete this weekly whiskey set. It's very fitting, as I'm sure all the players can use a drink right now while we wait for something new to get added to the game. I myself have been a little bit on a pepper binge recently, and I've been enjoying some Talisker 10-year, and honestly, I love the peat and the smokiness of this single malt. To the nose, it's strong, it's full, with big peat smoke, seaweed, citrus, and you know, some spiciness in the back, and then again to the taste, very strong, fresh ground black pepper, very sharp, and in the back I noticed some fruits and oak. and the finish is just spiciness that lingers. It's actually really quite pleasant, honestly. Now, if you are watching this video on Tuesday, July 14th, you can find Madame Nazar over by Brandywine Drop, just northwest of Ansburg. Check out my Discord for all Madame Nazar locations and daily challenge guide updates, updated in real time every single day. For the content this week, that is all news we have. Literally nothing fantastic here, no huge XP bonus, no huge gold bonus, and really no huge cash bonus either. The bonus 50% money on legendary bounties is nice though. If you want to cap out most of your money on legendary bounties, you need to spend 1.5 hours on the mission. I recommend the Edda Doyle mission because one, it's easier to complete, and also, even though most legendary bounties pay out the same, Edda Doyle does edge out the rest of the 9, and you'll get a total of $226, I believe, for completing that mission after spending 1.5 hours on it. With the 50% bonus, that's even more money, so that's really good for you. But that's it though. This was mostly a week of 40 and 50% discounts on cosmetic items. And that's our show today, and those were all the new Red Dead Online content update changes for Tuesday, July 14th. If we get any new information about a DLC update or anything else this week in the newswire, I'll update the description of this video and update my pinned comment below. It's worth keeping an eye out for something next week too, as Take-Two has their next investors earnings call August 3rd, so the chances of seeing an announcement the week before an update release or the update itself is naturally higher during this time than usual, and with the DLC pack being updated, this is definitely good news for us players. I'd love to get your thoughts and opinions in the comment section below regarding all of this weekly content update here in Red Dead Online. Hopefully you all enjoyed the video, and if you did, hopefully I earned your like on it. And of course, if you are new to the channel, consider hitting that subscribe button to stay up to date with all things Red Dead Online, Red Dead Redemption 2, and even Rockstar Games as a whole. We'll be sure to keep you guys up to date with updates, news, information, tips, tricks, and even leaks, and we'll keep you guys updated here on the channel daily, so make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you guys also want to follow me over on Twitch, Twitter, and Instagram, those are the best places to get connected with me outside of YouTube. I practically live on all three of those websites, and you can feel free to strike up a conversation and even ask me a question. Whatever it may be though, you can follow me at HazardousHDTV, and all of my social media links, including my Discord, can be found in the description down below. With that said, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all have a fantastic day, and I will see you guys in the next Red Dead Online video. Adios, amigos.